Now, you may be asking yourself, what's the point of all this? We're converting from, decimal to hexadecimal. We're doing this 2's complement. What is the purpose? And the answer, of course, is to impress your significant other. Nothing, will impress them more than whipping out some of these conversions. No. There's important things that happen, and in particularly in the early days of computing. I was going to say it was important. It's important now, but it was maybe more, you'd use it more. Now a lot of stuff happens kind of behind the scenes, but it's important to understand as a computer scientist what is happening behind the scenes, because that context helps you to address problems and things that come up. So, for example, when computers were first being created, everybody was kind of doing their own thing. And everybody was representing characters, for example, which everybody uses. So let's say the letter A. One person might have said, well, an A to me is whenever I have all zeros. That represents an A. But somebody else might have said, I actually do numbers first. So for me, it's a 1 that's represented by all zeros. And an A I actually represent after I've done the 10 digits, so I represent it with a 0000010. And so what happened as computers began be more popular is that the American National Standards Institute, or ANSI, created the American Standard Code for Information Interchange, or the ASCII table. And originally, the ASCII table was 7 bits. Now, the number of bits is important because I could ask a question about how many things can be represented. If I have 2 binary numbers, how many things can I represent? And the answer is, I could just go through them. I could say 0, 0 is one thing. 0, 1 could represent another thing. So this could represent an A. This one could represent a B. 1, 0, 1, 1. And that's it. I have nothing else with 2 digits. Okay? But the easier way, again, to figure that out is to say, what base am I in? I'm in base 2. And how many digits are there? Well, there's 2. So the answer is 4. Right? 4 things I can represent with 2 digits. Well, if so, in the ASCII table originally, there were 7 bits, but they were represented in binary. So we had 2 to the 7th, which gave us 128 different options, different things we could represent. And so they went through and assigned them. They said, let's standardize this. And so, if I go here and let's see if I can do this, pull up a ASCII table. Notice that they went through and said, if it's all zeros, it's a null. If it's a 1, that's a start of heading. And they went through and anyway, at some point here, we get into the alphabet. So here's the digits. And then at some point here, 65, we get to an A. Now, an A is represented by the decimal number 65, but notice what it says right here. HX, meaning hexadecimal, is a 41. And then it goes through octal for octal, and a lot of times they'll have the binary. They don't in this one. Let's see, just by out of curiosity. There we go, there's binary. And so, if you go pull up a document, a text document. Here's my alphabet. Well, there's my alphabet with uppercases. A 65 decimal is a 41 hexadecimal, which is a 1000001 binary. And that is how the A character is represented in a file. If I just pull up, if I just pull up Notepad here and I type a character, A, then, and I save this somewhere, what's going to happen is it's actually going to be saved in memory as a 01000001, assuming I'm using ASCII. Okay. Well, they decided eventually that wasn't quite enough, and so they went to 2 to the 8th, write it up a little higher. That gave us 256 different options, and that way in the ASCII table, so if we go look at this ASCII table again, maybe, then we got to the 127, and then they came up with what's called extended ASCII, which is what we use for many things today. So that added in all these other symbols that we see sometimes, accents and whatnot that are more commonly used. There's a copyright sign. So all these symbols were assigned a letter. And it could have just as easily been, they could have started out with 000 being A, but they came up with the standardization, and now everybody uses that. Well, eventually, as computers got around the world, there's other languages that use completely different symbols. And so they eventually moved to you can save text files as Unicode files. And if you go to Unicode, then they moved to 16 bits to store the characters. So we went from 2 to 8 to 2 to the 16th, which is a lot. You can do that math if you want to. It's a lot of different characters, and that way they can represent, actually I know what it is, 65,356. How do I do it? It's a lot. Anyway, so they can do all the Russian characters and Arabic characters and Chinese characters and that's in Unicode. But the problem is, if you're storing 16 bits in a file for each character, that's twice as many bits than you were for ASCII, and so the file becomes twice as big. And so if you don't need the extra characters in Unicode, you can store your file as an ASCII file, and it will only store 8 bits per character. But if we were to go save this file and look at it, it is going to be 8 bits in size because we stored one character, and each character is 8 bits or 1 byte. And so when you start to see these file sizes, so if I just save this out somewhere to the desktop, and then pull that up. So on the desktop, go look at the blah file. Well, it's gonna show as bigger. Let me see if I can. Zero bytes. It's not gonna show well the way I've got it set up, but that's how, so when we get a file, how do you get to your file sizes? Well, if I write the word Spencer, each of those characters is a 1-bit character stored in as an ASCII character. So the S is the capital S. If we go back to our ASCII table, is a 123. That's octal. It's a 53 in hexadecimal. It's an 83 in decimal, but in binary, it's a 01010010. And so on and so forth. So that's one place that we see this and we use these conversions is in the ASCII table. Where else? What about images? We're hitting the magic 10-minute mark, so I'm going to go ahead and stop and continue this discussion on in one last video. Spencer out.